write down all of you the principle of superposition of the wave. So, like I told you at the start, superposition is what? When two waves meet. Okay, so we need to understand what will happen if two waves meet. Fine. So it is a straightforward thing. So if let's say y1 is equal to f1 x comma t and y2 is equal to f2 x comma t. These two waves, if they meet, they will give you y is equal to y1 plus y2. As simple as that. You need to just algebraically add them up. Fine. Nothing else you have to do. Just add them. So feel free to use sine A plus sine B is equal to 2 sine A plus B by 2 cos A minus B by 2. So all those things are valid. Okay. So feel free to do all of that. Okay. So basically, this is what when two waves meet will happen. Now, since we are only focusing on the sinusoidal wave primarily, so let us discuss what exactly will happen with the sinusoidal wave. Okay, so we will take a special kind of situation. The assumptions or the situation is this. The situation is that we are taking two waves having same frequency and same wavelength. Okay, so we will take two cases inside this situation. Case number one, amplitude is same for both and there is a phase difference. I'll discuss what is the phase difference. And case number two, amplitudes are different and so are phases also are different from each other. Okay, so first we'll take a simpler scenario, case number one. Okay, so how we can write down two equations, two waves that are meeting? I can write it as, let's take amplitude as small a sine of kx minus omega t, one of the wave. Second wave is, let's say this, a sine of kx minus omega t. Why? Because frequency and wavelength are same, but there's a phase difference. So I'll add phi to it. Okay, so phase difference is what between these two? Phase difference is phi. So phase difference phi doesn't depend upon time. It is fixed. Okay, this scenario is also called superposition of two coherent waves. What are coherent waves? For which the phase difference doesn't depend on time. It will happen only when frequencies are equal. If frequencies are not equal, let's say if you have kx minus omega 1t, one phase, minus if you have omega 2t plus phi, you can see the phase difference depends on time. Okay, phase difference depends on time. It will be independent of time only when the two frequencies are equal. Okay, but anyways, take these two waves and superpose them. These two waves are meeting each other. So all of you tell me what you get y as equal to. Have you simplified it? You can use sin A plus sin B formula. Let me know once you're done. Type in, once you're done, just type in that it is done. Sine A plus sine B is 2 sine A plus B by 2 cos A minus B by 2. Use that. Are you getting this? 2a cos phi by 2 into sine of kx minus omega t plus phi by 2. How many of you are getting this? Okay. So now, does this look like a wave equation? Is this a wave equation? Yes or no? If this is the wave equation, what is the amplitude? What is the amplitude of the wave? Correct. Good. So new amplitude of the wave is 2a cos of phi by 2. Now one thing you need to see here, amplitude depends on phi. Okay. What if is equal to 0? What if it is equal to 0 for some value of phi? What does it mean if this is equal to 0? If amplitude becomes zero for some value of phi, there will be some phase difference between the two waves, phi, for which 2a cos phi by 2 is zero. Let's say phi is pi. Phi is, let's say, 180 degree. So these two waves will meet, amplitude will become zero. What does it mean? It means that the two waves, when they meet, they destroy each other. Okay? So let's say this is one of the wave. When this wave meet this one, When they superpose, they will yield nothing. This is what it means. This never happens with the masses when two masses meet. But it can happen that one wave meet other wave and nothing comes out. Okay. For what values of phi, this will be equal to zero. For the values for which cos of phi by 2 is equal to zero. So phi by 2 should be equal to what? 2n plus 1 pi by 2. For an odd multiple of pi by 2, cos of phi by 2 will become 0. Okay. So phi should be equal to 2n plus 1 times pi. N can be anything. N is an integer. N belongs to integer. It can be 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, could be anything. If phi is equal to this, then these two waves will meet and they will destroy each other. Are you getting it? This is called destructive interference. Destructive interference. Or you can say destructive superposition, anything. All right. They are not oppositely moving. They're not oppositely moving. You can see that this wave is moving in positive x direction, kx minus omega t. This also moves in the positive x direction. Will they destroy each other at any value? No. Just now I told you, for this value of phi, if this phi is equal to pi, or 2 pi, not 2 pi, sorry, pi, an odd multiple of pi, pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, 7 pi, 9 pi, like that. If phi is that, then these two waves will meet and destroy each other. Is it clear now? How it comes? The amplitude you equate it to 0 and see what is the value of phi for which amplitude will become 0. And you can see that. This is the value of phi that comes up. Anyone has any other doubt? Clear? Okay. Now, let us see case number 2. The last thing that we are doing today is case number 2. What was the case number 2? Amplitudes are different and there's a phase difference. So, y1 is equal to a1 sine of kx minus omega t, and y2, this is not from your NCRT, this you can treat like a numerical, okay, rather than a derivation, because it is beyond NCRT. This is a situation. Okay, now I want to add them up. Okay, so y is equal to y1, sorry, plus y2. Is trigonometry done in mathematics for you? Trigonometry is done? Okay, great. So it's here is one of the trigonometry question which you have to solve. So how will you add these two trigonometric equation so that I want to add these two trigonometric function so that it looks like a wave equation. I want it to look like wave equation, like a sine kx minus omega t plus phi. There are two sine functions. I want only one. Look like a wave function. Wave equation. Try doing it. Spend 1 or 2 minutes. It will be interesting trigonometry question. Should I give you a hint? Should I give you a hint? The hint is expand this as sine of A plus B. A is kx minus omega t and B is phi. So let me expand it. Like all of you are stuck. Anyone got any this thing? Sine of A plus B is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Okay. So cos of kx minus omega t sine of phi. Now what to do? What do you think we should do next? Why I have opened it like this? What do you think? Anyone? Correct. Good. So you can take sine of kx minus omega t common. You will have a1 plus a2 cos of phi plus you can take cos of kx minus omega t and you have a2 sine of phi common like this. Okay, so you can see that it looks like a sine of kx minus omega t plus b cos of kx minus omega t. Capital A is this, capital B is this. Now, have you learned how to simplify this as a single trigonometric function? A sine theta plus B cos theta, how you simplify it? Or how you put it as a single trigonometric function? Do you know this? What to do next? Tell me ideas. I mean, you could be wrong. If I were in your place, I would have been definitely wrong because it's not something which you can guess directly. So at least you should think and answer something. Okay, Gayatri got it. Take sine of 5/2 square. Okay, what you do in these cases, this is something which is very common, okay? So you need to learn this trick. If you are doing it for the first time, it's okay. But you should remember this trick for such situations in which you get this format. A sine theta plus B cos theta. Whenever you get something like this and you want a single trigonometric function, you can multiply and divide by root over A square plus B square. It's a common trick, don't worry. Now you know it. Root over A square plus B square. Sine of, okay, by the way, can you guess why I have done like this? At least that you can guess. Why I have multiplied divided by root over A square plus B square. Any guesses on that? All of you, why I have written like this? I can take cos theta, I can say that it is equal to this. Why I've divided by root over a square plus b square? Because this thing can never be more than one. So I can say this is cos theta. If this is cos theta, what is this? Sin theta. Automatically it becomes sin theta. B divided by root over a square plus b square. Okay. So it becomes what? Sin a cos theta plus cos a sin theta. So it will become root over a square plus b square sin of kx minus omega t plus theta, where theta is what? Theta is such that tan theta is b by a. B by a. What was b? A2 sin of phi, and a was a1 plus a2 cos of phi. Does it look like a wave equation, everyone? Is it a wave equation? It's a wave equation, okay? And the amplitude is what? Amplitude is root over a square plus b square, which is a1 plus a2 cos of phi whole square plus a2 sine of phi whole square. So when you simplify it, you will get under root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos of phi. When you look at this, what comes in your mind? This is the amplitude. If amplitudes are different, vector addition come in your mind or not? Vector addition, right? Okay, so this is what happens if two waves of different amplitude, they meet, their amplitude will result to this much. Now, looking at this expression, I want you to tell me what is the maximum amplitude and what is the minimum amplitude. Everyone, maximum and minimum. You can change phi. Maximum is when cos of phi is 1. So A max is root over A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2. This will be root over A1 plus A2 whole square. That will be A1 plus A2. This is maximum amplitude. Minimum is when? What should be the value of cos of phi for minimum? Cos of phi should be minus 1. All right. So A minimum is equal to root over A1 square plus A2 square minus of 2A1 A2, which is what? Root over A1 minus A2 the whole square, which is A1 minus A2 mod. So this is minimum, this is maximum. Okay. So I have 2 minutes. Tell me, any one of you have any doubts from anywhere? Anyone, any doubt from anywhere? Whatever we have done today. Please ask doubts. Everyone, I'm not going to leave you early anyways. How is it a vector sum? See, it is not a vector sum. It looks like a vector sum. Okay. Vector sum, when you add two vectors, the sum of the vector is, isn't it a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta? So it looks something like that. This is what I was saying. Any other doubt? How a square was cos theta and other expression becomes sin theta and how we get tan theta, okay? See, I am assuming that if this is cos theta, this is an assumption, okay? Or this is an introduction. I am saying let us assume this is cos theta. So sin theta will be this. How? Because sin theta is root over 1 minus cos square theta. You can check that. Or you can see one more thing. This square plus that square is 1. So if this is cos theta, this will be sin theta. Okay, this you can do it your own. Sin theta is 1 minus cos square theta. Put cos theta is equal to this. Sin theta will come out to be this. Okay. Now tan theta, how it is this? You can divide sin theta and cos theta. You'll get tan theta equals to b by a. And what is b? B is this. And what is a? A is that. Understood? Is it assumed for some value of theta that is not decided? Yes. I can assume it is some theta for which tan theta is b by a. Okay. Why does it look like a vector? See, you may not be aware of something called phasor. These are the rotating vectors. Okay. Which I don't want to talk right now. I don't want to confuse you. So we will discuss it in 12th. This comes in 12th. Okay, phasor. Right now you just assume that yes, it looks like it. Looks like this because it comes out to be like that. Okay. That's it. Any other doubt? All right, guys. So I'm going to send you another assignment. Make sure you are struggle with the assignment and solve it. This is the last, this thing, chapter. Make sure you do class 11 physics very, very properly. You know, there are two reasons to it. Because if you do 11th physics properly, 12th will be a cakewalk. 12th is a very simple physics curriculum. We will complete the physics curriculum by October 1st week itself next year. And then we can get down to the revision of things by problem solving. So those who are doing it properly, diligently, will see that rapidly they will, increase their capability at the end, because everything will fall in place at the end. All right. Okay. So that's it from my side. We will meet next week. And next week, we are going to solve a lot of problems on this chapter.